Hey everybody, Matt Busby again for Track Tuesdays. What we're talking about today is curbing. The on-track curbing for the racetrack is really, really important to making the car go fast, where you can use it, where you can't use it, how impactful it is, what different types we've got, all that kind of fun stuff. That's what we're going to cover today. So what we're standing on today is what we call Melbourne curbing, or what most people call it is gators. So you can see, kind of looking at the curb, how it kind of elevates from the racetrack surface up to a raised edge, which is about 2 inches. So it's at grade or at asphalt level on the front, and 2 inches on the back. And you can kind of imagine the harder you hit it, the more bouncy it's going to get. But there's also a little bit of a trick there. The faster you hit it, the more speed that you roll over these, the less time the shock has to go up and down and up and down, and the less upsetting it is to the chassis. So at 30 miles an hour, these will rattle a filling loose. At 130 miles an hour, it just makes a little bit of noise. So, you know, you can kind of use these to your advantage to kind of widen the racetrack a little bit at certain speeds. In certain areas like turn 2, turn 10, you kind of want to stay off of them because it'll upset the car and give you a really hard time on turn-in or mid-corner. So the other type of curbing that we have out here at NCM Motorsports Park is Carolina curbing, or just regular old curbing for what most people see. You can tell that it's really, really wide, a lot wider than it looks when you're in a car doing laps. And the grade is really interesting because the first... the first 18 inches kind of has like a little bit of a soft ramp up to it, and then it all of a sudden kind of levels out and goes all the way back to the back. So the difference in the racetrack and the back of the curbing is about 4.5 to 5 inches, which is a lot, especially at a place like 1A or 1B, where you already have the car loaded up, the suspension's already compressed. If you ask it to go over a curb, you don't have any more suspension travel. So what, you know, just generally, depending on the car, the weight, all that kind of stuff. If you've already got the suspension already loaded all the way up and you ask it for more travel because of curbing, generally it doesn't have anywhere to go, so it translates it to the tire and it'll push you out. Slide the car, throw it in the air, something like that. This stuff is really, really important because, again, a lot like the Melbourne curbing or the gator strips, you can use it to kind of widen the racetrack in certain areas. The other element of curbing that we kind of want to talk about is when they're wet. Obviously, painted surfaces, when they get wet, they get a little bit slippery, a lot more slippery than the asphalt. We use a special FIA grade paint from a company called Drew Paints. It's pretty expensive, but it's got ground up glass or ground up media in it. So it's a really, really fine mixture to give it a lot more grip in the wet and a lot more grip in the dry. So it's not something that you want to rely on, but it's definitely not, it's not like a painted surface on like in the interstate or in a parking lot or something like that where it just gets like ice slick. We can use this curbing to help turn the car. So just generally right here at turn two, if we're going through, we're going to get to apex. If we're having a hard time getting the car to turn in, we can put our right front on the curb and it'll kind of pull the car a little bit. Again, at the consequence of a little bit more suspension load. But if you're comfortable with that and you want to kind of play around with what it can do, what it can help you do or not, you can use the curbing to your advantage. 1A is a great example where the 1A curbing, the way the grade works, the way the racetrack and the runoff works, you can kind of take a whole bunch of curbing. We've got a little bit of video of my Corvette doing that. It's a little bit too much. So that's the question we'll leave with you guys. How much curb is too much curb? What curbs do you guys have questions on? Where do you want to hit them? Where do you not want to hit them? Tell us in the comments and see you next week.